After a much talked about debut of the Moto Razr, Samsung has released its very first flip-style smartphone in India, and as expected, both the devices were immediately compared because these are the only two devices that come with a flip-style form factor. However, since the foldable technology is still in the experimental phase, the prices of these phones are usually high, and we think the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip is a fit device to test waters. So Samsung called us for an experience with the Z Flip at their office earlier this month. In the limited time, we tried our best to find out whether is it worth the price that the wishful early buyers want to pay for the Z Flip. The Samsung Galaxy Z Flip is a compact device, and due to its small footprint, it is lighter on specs compared to the fresh Galaxy S20 series from Samsung, although it costs higher than the three phones. It's not that the Z Flip has an inferior internals. It comes with last year's flagship chipset, which is the Snapdragon 855 Plus, alongside 8GB of RAM and 256GB of onboard storage. But note that it's not the most interesting thing about Samsung Galaxy Z Flip. So no points for guessing. It's the foldable design that makes it a very interesting piece of technology. Its design can turn heads. Taking it out of pocket in public will make people ask about it, for sure. The foldable design is unique, stylish, and the best part is that it does not take away the feel of using a regular Android smartphone. It comes in three color variants: black, which looks like most of the glassy phones, a gold variant, and the purple one, which you can just see in front of your screens. It has a shiny and blingy finish, yet not resistant to smudges. The cover has a tiny 1.1-inch interactive AMOLED display, and it is placed right to the rear camera setup. The cover display does not offer a lot of room, but it still packs in the essentials when it comes to notifications and quick information like call, time, and battery percentage. It just has enough space to fit in small text, so you get a scrolling notification at most times. You can scroll through the various sets of information on display, plus there's a way to tap a notification on the cover display and then open up the phone to see the app in full. Like the main display, it can also be double tapped to wake, but we are still unsure if the tiny screen comes out as handy as the bigger displays on the Fold and the Moto Razr. When unfolded, one could easily mistake the Z Flip for a typical Android phone until you don't notice the light crease across the middle of the display. Otherwise, the phone's footprint is much smaller when folded. That's one of the big reasons that make the flip phones more desirable. The design of the Z Flip makes it infinitely easier to hold and pocket than regular smartphones. The candy bar style of the Galaxy Z Flip, when unfolded, makes it distinct from the mini tablet like Galaxy Fold. It has a 6.7-inch Full HD Plus screen with 21:9:9 aspect ratio, which feels exceptionally tall in hand. We feel the only downside of that tall form factor is that people with small hands might struggle a bit to open it and close it or operate it with one hand, especially for tasks like pulling the notification and quick setting tab from the top of the screen. What's commendable here is that Samsung has used a thin glass layer above the panel, unlike the vulnerable plastic OLEDs of the Razr and the Galaxy Fold. There has been a huge debate around the use of thin glass on the display, but we felt the screen to be smoother to swipe across and better to touch in comparison to the Galaxy Fold and even the Moto Razr. One potential issue with the ultra-thin glass is that the crease still remains in center of the screen, but thankfully it is not as dramatic as it was on the Galaxy Fold. But then again, it's across a smaller screen and the unit we tested was brand new and wasn't being folded as many times. Another very crucial element of the design on the Z Flip is its hinge. While it's too early to comment on the hinge durability, it is right to say that it functions very seamlessly. Folding and unfolding of the Z Flip felt a little tight, but we are sure the more you use the Galaxy Z Flip, you'll find a natural way to open and close the cover of the phone. Although the Z Flip is more expensive than the S20 Ultra, there are only two cameras on the back. The first one is a 12 megapixel f2.2 aperture ultra-wide camera, and the other one is a wide-angle shooter that has a 12 megapixel sensor with f1.8 aperture. The front camera is packed in a small cutout on top of the display, so when you have the phone unfolded, the front camera takes up the selfie and video calling duty. But in the limited experience, we can certainly say that performance was comparable to something that we have seen on the Galaxy S10. On paper, we have found the camera quality and the chipset to be nearly the best, but not the best. The title will likely go to the S20 series, which packs more robust internals and better camera sensors. While those phones are cheaper than the Z Flip, it is still going to be a tough call for people to afford either of them. The Z Flip comes with a 3300 mAh battery in comparison to Motorola's smaller 2510 mAh cell, which had our doubts in the beginning. And it's a no-brainer that anyone would favor for a bigger battery, even when it comes to foldable smartphones. Samsung is not shying away from accepting that Z Flip is an expensive phone. Given that there are only two in the market and only one is available to purchase, the Z Flip makes a more sensible option if you have made your mind to buy a flip phone. Z Flip is not just a flaunt-worthy device, it is a head-turner for sure. And it comes with inferior hardware compared to the S20 series of phones. But if we see, it comes with last year's top-end specifications like the Snapdragon 855 Plus, ample of RAM and tons of storage for every kind of user. We are yet to test the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip for a longer period of time, but as of now, we can confidently say that it is a better flip phone than the Moto Razr. But still, if you need everything perfect and top-notch, you should go for Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra in this price range, because you're still spending a lakh on this phone, and until and unless you want to flaunt the Z Flip in front of your friends, the S20 makes more sense to us. So this was our first impression of the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip. We might be getting the device for a longer period of time to test it and come with a full review. But until then, you guys can stay subscribed to TechRadar India for more such videos, and do let us know your thoughts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.